From NBC News, this is Today with Katie Couric and Matt Lauer. Live from Studio 1A in Rockefeller Plaza.
Inside Studio 1A, I'm Matt Lauer along with Katie Couric. And coming up in this half hour, a Florida bus driver and two students have been arrested after a school bus fight caught on tape. We're going to find out how this happened.
And also ahead, if you can't face getting out of bed this morning because your boss is a bully, we've got some important advice. In fact, we're kicking off a three-part series that will help you cope with the thorny issues of office politics. For example, what if your boss is younger than you are?
Right.
What if your boss is a different sex or different gender, obviously, and that can create some problems as well?
But this bullying thing is a real problem because sometimes they pick on someone to the point where there's, you know, you can't go up there and fight back against your boss for fear of being fired.
Right, although I think that's why they have human resources.
No question. and go as a group. That's an important
thing. Really?
Because it's usually happening to more than one person. And we're back at 7:41 this morning. We're kicking off a special three-part series called Who's the Boss? Today, how to cope when your boss is a bully. While most managers at least try to be fair, as NBC's Ann Thompson reports, almost everyone has their own story of dealing with a nightmare boss.
Monday morning, and millions of Americans gird themselves for another work week under a bully boss.
He was a bully, a know-it-all, and didn't know anything.
A real-life menace Hollywood loves and loathes.
Try something new tonight, like making money.
I was just wondering if...
No! You can't have the afternoon off.
The irrational screamer.
My hospital, my rules.
The control freak who make you cringe.
I called the inn. They said all they can give you is a ground floor single in the new wing.
Did you tell them it was me?
But the true life version can be traumatic.
He would throw bagels. He would throw the phone.
On the third time, turn in a report, crumple it up in your face, throw it at you.
All creating a culture of fear. A strategy once thought to make employees produce more.
They all feel like they're helpless. They all feel like they're isolated, but they're not.
Judith Glazer works with both bully bosses and their employees. She insists workers have more options than just quitting.
Yet it's not easy to stand up to a bully alone. So what can you do? Experts say in these cases, there may be safety in numbers.
If they are a solo person going to human resources, it's very easy for the boss to say, you know what, that was a bad employee, let's get rid of them. But if it's a group of people, it changes the whole thing.
Workers who feel they are abused, searching for strategies, and hoping at last, life will imitate art. For Today, Ann Thompson, NBC News, New York.
Gary Namie is the director of the Workplace Bullying and Trauma Institute. Doctor, good morning. Nice to see you.
Good morning.
So the bully that you face in the workplace, is that just a grown-up version of the bully you'd face on the playground as a kid?
Yes, but much more practiced. They've had a lifetime of intimidation, and they're convinced that they are winners and everyone else is a loser.
And they don't only pick on the weakest one in the group. They sometimes pick on a strong subordinate.
Well, that's actually the paradox. They'll go after people who threaten them. The person who's more technically skilled has better social skills are the ones they want to take down.
What's the difference between a tough boss and an abusive boss?
A tough manager is going to be one who, when there's misery to spread around, spreads it fairly. And there's tough deadlines for everyone. And when it's over, there's going to be a celebration, period. Right. But the bully boss, the abusive one, is going to zero in laser-like and pick on one or two targets at a time.
So you're talking abusive versus a Vince Lombardi motivator, tough guy type thing.
Exactly.
So is there safety in numbers? If you are being picked on, should you go around and find out if other people are being picked on the same way?
Absolutely, and you do it for your own mental health because you feel isolated, you're convinced you're the only one. There's power in numbers. The trouble is coworkers get paralyzed by fear and they turn away. And if you were just to say, find out you're not alone, there's tremendous power if they'd coalesce.
Let's talk about your tips for surviving a bully boss. We'll go through them quickly. First, name it. What do you mean by that?
Power in naming it. You know it's not you. Stop the self-blame.
Take time off.
You need time off because of the emotional overwhelming nature of being bullied.
But isn't that a little bit like running from the problem?
You've got to run to do a couple things. You're going to repair, restore, check your mental health, your physical health. You may have legal options. I mean, in a quarter of the cases, discrimination plays a role. And start to build a business case, not an emotional case, that the boss is too expensive to keep.
And once you've made that case, then expose the bully to human resources.
To the highest level person you can, not always human resources. And let them try and take the bully out. And if they don't, you've got to find alternate work.
Are companies taking this more seriously than they have in the past?
They are in Canada because there's a law in Quebec They take it seriously when there's a law. In the U.S., however, very progressive companies that take depression seriously and stress seriously are starting to pay attention.
All right, now let's take the next step. We've got the bully boss here. This next category is the abusive boss, all right? And here are your tips for that. Don't personalize the attack.
Exactly. Keep it external. You know that you didn't cause it, you didn't make it happen, so it reduces the self-blame. I'm not talking about ducking personal responsibility, Matt. I'm talking about getting it straight. You were basically, it's usually the workplace pressure in this case, the non-abusive case. It's just the nature of the work.
All right, alleviate the stress.
Diet.
Again, take some time off.
All the stress management tips, and I just want to hit, besides diet, exercise, and life management, have a support system. If you are isolated, you will be more stressed than the other person.
Is that what you mean by regain control of the work life?
Well, regain control of the work life is when an inordinate amount of work comes your way. Manage your boss. Come back. You can't have 27 priorities. Help them, teach them how to reprioritize.
And you say look for alternatives, but I mean, look, if you're in your 40s and 50s and you got a job that pays you fairly well, it's not that easy to pick up and move on to another workplace.
And couched that way, it sounds overwhelming. The truth is, just like a battered spouse, they stay because they don't perceive alternatives. And then look at how everyone watches them and say, well, if it was so bad, she should have got out. There always are alternatives to life-threatening stress.
A couple of quick points to make. One time, you mentioned coworkers sometimes do nothing.
Yes.
Sometimes the coworker is actually hoping the person being abused gets fired or quits because they want that job.
They get co-opted. Bobby Knight was very keen in pointing out that the player he choked was voted off the team by the co-player, the team.
And how successful, how much impact do employee gripe sessions have? The employees go out for a drink and they gripe and moan about the boss.
To magnify the misery. I don't see it stepping up. It can't confirm that they're not alone, but unless they start planning action, how are we going to go back and do something about it? It's just venting.
Dr. Gary Namie. Gary, thanks very much. I appreciate it.